Hi everyone, Ezekiel O'Callaghan here to talk to you about a new species of hadrosaur coming from the Cerro del Pueblo formation of Mexico, named Tladophis gallorum. It was actually very closely related to animals like Parasaurolophus, as well as Coronosaurus and Blossisaurus. Together, these make up the tribe Parasaurolophini, and with this new species in there, it helps to show some of the diversity that they had that we didn't quite understand earlier. A large part of this comes from the crest, which, while similar to animals like Parasaurolophus, is slightly differently shaped and is much narrower, with the internal structures also showing different patterns in essentially how they related to one another. This means its calls would have been far different from animals like Parasaurolophus, and could have potentially been part of the reason that these animals speciated into different genera. This is actually something that we think happens in birds quite a bit. It's called sympatric speciation, and essentially it occurs when a single species of bird has slightly different calls within a single population. Certain members of that population prefer one call over the other, and vice versa for the other call. This means that essentially there's a selection pressure for each of those two separate calls to diverge separately. And then you get two species that are entirely separate from one another, although closely related, and that are still living within the same environment. Hopefully by getting internal scans of even more hadrosaurs and potentially even other dinosaurs, we can try and better understand how they may have speciated. And being able to understand how these speciation events occurred on a broad timescale can better help us understand how exactly life did get to where it is today.